Thank you. If ever a hand is in need, you know that I'll be holding on. Know that the peace that comes from above is the same everlasting love.
thank you for joining us this morning. If I could ask everyone to please stand as the service will commence. The Lord is my shepherd. I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He refreshes my soul. He guides me along the right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. At the behest of the family, we would now like to take 1 minute of complete silence this morning. Thank you. So Father, this morning, as we gather together to celebrate a life well lived of Amma Frimpomaa, we ask that you would bring comfort and strength to Christina, her daughter, the rest of the family, friends, members of KTLCC that are gathered here this morning, that you would bring your strength and your peace and your comfort, and that, Lord, you would show us the way forward in your loving kindness, in your grace. Would you remind each and every one of us that you are Lord, that you are sovereign, that you rule and you reign in each heart and every mind in this place. We pray that your presence would manifest and be here, that your glory would descend, that we would take time today to acknowledge and celebrate a life well lived, a daughter returning home into the arms of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And so we thank you for her life today. We give you praise for her life. And we honor you in this place. And we pray that your name will be magnified and glorified, even through our sorrow and our sadness, our distress and our disappointment. Be with each and every one of us. Comfort us, I pray, in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. This morning, please do take your seats this morning. You should have an order of service with you, and in that order of service we have a number of hymns and Bible readings that we will go through this morning, and so I'm going to invite Roseman and Jordan to the platform as we will sing our first hymn, How Great Thou Art. So if I could ask us all to be upstanding, the words are on page 4. Thank you.
Oh, I will come back and take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am. You know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you're going, so how can we know the way? Jesus answered, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Praise be to the Almighty God. Amen.
Thank you very much, Mr. Birch. We're now going to have our second hymn, which is on page 5 of your order of service this morning. It is well with my soul. So if I could invite everyone to please stand as we sing this. Thank you.
Oh. Thank you. Preaching is useless, and so is your faith. More than that, we are then found to be false witnesses about God, for we have testified about God that he raised Christ from the dead, but he did not raise him if in fact the dead are not raised. For if the dead are not raised, then Christ has not been raised either. And if Christ has not been raised, your faith is futile. So you are still in your sins. Then those also who have fallen asleep in Christ are lost. If only for this life we have hope in Christ, we are of all people most to be pitied. Praise God.
Thank you very much. We are now going to have a number of tributes for Amma, and so I would like to invite Mrs. Christabel Larte forward to bring the first tribute. Thank you.
Good morning, church. Tribute to a dear. Amma Frimpomaa was popularly known amongst her friends as Eno. The name Eno was used to address the elderly and grown-up women, mainly amongst the Ashanti tribe, and this is how we called each other. So you will hear in my tribute addressing her as Eno rather than Amma. Our eyes are once again filled with tears as we stand here where you lay. We are full of sadness that you are no longer here, and our pain is only soothed by the memories we hold so dear of you. Our hearts keep breaking each time we hear your name. It has been the hardest thing to lose you so suddenly, as you meant so much to us. The memories we had of you will never fade away. When I think of you, Eno, the following words come into mind. Mother, dedicated, hardworking, energetic, supportive, loving, kind, loud, jovial, funny, helpful, and many more. A truly beautiful soul, you will live on forever in my heart and in my mind. Despite our moments and some of the misunderstandings we had along the way, our friendship was great. Eno loved children and always played mother for many children. It is not surprising that you see most of us dressed uniformly in this cloth called Obapa, meaning good mother or good woman. I remember the many times she cared for our children whenever my late husband and I had to attend an outing or a function in the evenings. When I was admitted in hospital for 3 weeks, Eno took care of our girls as their dad was busy at work, and she would feed them and bring them with Christina to visit me every evening via public transport. When I finally delivered my baby and was discharged, Eno dashed to the hospital to support me even before my husband could get there. she came home with us and gave our son his very first bath. Eno played an active part in the Northwest Angels Choir. This group was founded in the year 2000 by the late Madam Grace Tagle of blessed memory, and was made up of children of the Ghanaian Fellowship members who lived in the northwest of London, hence the name Northwest Angels. These children were taught the gospel, as well as to dance and to sing in our native languages. They always had a slot to perform at all our Ghanaian celebrations, and were sometimes invited to perform at other churches. Eno always ensured that the children were well taken care of. She was so down to earth and assisted in teaching and dancing along with the children, helping them mostly with the meanings and pronunciations of some of the difficult vernacular words. This was Eno's speciality and always a joyful time for her. When I organized a party or had massive cooking to do for any event, especially our Ghanaian celebrations, Eno would be there to help with the preparations, help to serve, as well as stay till the end to help with the cleaning. She was very helpful, supportive, and serviceable in a way that warmed her heart. At any time, she was there to play her thoughtful part. During my bereavement, Eno would call me from time to time to encourage me and then make jokes for me to laugh so as to take my mind off my low moments. At the same time, she was also very sensitive to the times when I would not speak and needed to be left alone. She knew the times when it was best not to say anything. Eno, I will miss the phone calls, where you would start by checking up every member of my family, both here and abroad, mentioning them all by name before starting our conversations. Not to forget our late night conversations and jokes that made us laugh until tears filled our eyes and we could laugh no more. I wish I had just one more chance to see that tender smile and to laugh with you again, my friend, just for a little while. The fact that you are no longer here will always cause me pain. Thank you for your kindness, for your understanding and the difference it made. The special memories of you will always make me smile. You are forever in my heart until we meet again. Gone too soon, but not forgotten. Amma, Deye. Honey, Deye. Eno, Deye. Nyaminfomusie. Nyaminfomusie. Nyaminfomusie.
Tributes coming from the KT Ghana Fellowship, the first of which will be brought by Gifty Okoku.
From all your labors. forget you. Your loved ones you've left behind are in the Lord's hands, and He will lead, guide, and bless them all. Well done, Sister Amma. You fought the good fight, you ran the race, and have finished the course of faith. Now awaits you the crown of righteousness which the Lord Himself will give you. We, your brothers and sisters at KT Ghana Fellowship, will always cherish the special and blessed times we shared with you. Rest in peace, Sister Amma Frimpomaa. Rest in the bosom of our dear Jesus Christ till we meet again face to face. Amma, Demrifa Dwie, Demrifa Dwie, Nyamemfa Ukrensi, Deye. Thank you.
Amen. Thank you very much, Sister Gifty. We also have a short tribute from Sir Alex Kwache, who's unable to be here this morning, and this tribute will be read on behalf of Mr. Richard Kennedy. Thank you.
Good morning, everybody. Reading this tribute on behalf of Sir Alex Kwache, who happened not to be here with us today. A tribute to Sister Amma, Madam Amma Frimpomaa, a friend, a sister, and fellow soldier in the body of Christ, KTLCC. She has been of my friend for many years. I thank God for her heart of devotion and service as a steward at KTLCC. She has been a genuine friend who cared for my well-being and regularly called me to discuss matters. She sought my counsel on many issues that affected her and needed decision making. She was a dedicated member of the KT Ghana Fellowship from its inception. A good human being, and will be sorely missed. The righteous judge, Jesus Christ, will give her a crown of faithfulness for her services to the kingdom's work here in England. Shalom. Alex Kwache. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Richard. We'd now like to invite Esther Bromby forward to bring the next tribute. Thank you.
So, when corruptible has put on incorruption, and this mortal has put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is your sting? O hate, where is your victory? 1 Corinthians 15:54-55. Amma, Miriam, which means my sister. That's how we called ourselves. I'm acutely aware of your absence, and the thought of not hearing your voice is incomprehensible. Amma, you were one of the few who genuinely made me feel I belonged when I joined KT, and definitely the only close friendship I developed over the years in our church. You were so approachable and welcoming, with the ability to make one feel so at ease. Amma, you were truly a Proverbs 31 woman who used your cooking and housekeeping skills to serve others whenever there was an opportunity to do so. I admired you for your parenting skills. Your relationship with Christina Equia was close friendship balanced with discipline within the principles of your Christian faith. You ensured your London-born and bred child knew her culture and taught her to speak your native dialect with all the proverbial Asante speech and mannerisms, and are there in the linguist to speak to you to a queer. Amma, your conversations were full of laughter. In your presence, moodiness and shyness would vanish. You would encourage and exhort that one would feel at peace. Amma had the gifts of helps. She was an encourager and full of exhortation with the word of God. Amma, you knew how to make one feel good about themselves and never join in any pity party, irrespective of all that's going on. I don't remember any occasion I saw you angry. You were so humble and respectful, the young and old. In our last phone conversation, I was encouraging you to come to church after we all got too comfortable doing church in our 90s. Little did I know, it was just a matter of weeks. I know, as it was your tendency, you would not share, you are unwell, as you did not want to burden anyone. I'm still in shock, Miriam, as my heart ached thinking of Akia. Little did I know, you have imparted to her even your spiritual gifts. She has been my encourager. I take my comfort knowing you are with the lover of your soul and can visualize you, your awe and wild grace to the Lord. I take comfort knowing you left us a well-rounded woman who also loves the Lord. Auntie Amma, Obapa, till we join you, keep dancing.
Thank you very much, Esther. We'd now like to invite Mr. Nathaniel Frimpomaa to bring tribute. Thank you.
Auntie loved me and treated me as her own. From the day that I was born, she was present, taking care of me alongside my mother. I cannot express the love that she had for me. Consistent and faithful love. Even in sickness, she was always present, checking up on me and my well-being, ensuring that I was in good health, and spending time with her was a great time. She always came up with thoughtful jokes to lighten the mood of any scenario. She always came with breakers. I'm now more aware of how important it is to spend time with people and enjoy it. The presence of others, and just take time to spend. She has had a great influence on Christina and aided her throughout life and protected her. She was a great mother. May she be remembered in passing, and may she be remembered for the change that she brought upon us. Amongst the church and amongst family and everything else. As a tribute to her, I'd like to read one of her favorite passages, Psalm 91. Whoever dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress. My God, I put my trust. Surely he will save you from the followers' share and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with his feathers. Under his wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness will be your shield and rampart. You will not fear the terror of the night, nor the arrow that flies by the day, nor the pestilence that stalks the darkness, nor the plague that destroys midday. A thousand may fall by your side, even 10,000. At your right hand, yeah, you will not come, but it will not come near you. You will only observe with your eyes and what the punishment of the wicked. The Lord said, if you say the Lord is my refuge, and you may make your place the Most High, your dwelling, and no harm will overtake you. No disaster will come near you, your tent. No disaster, for you will command angels and conserve you. To guard you in all your ways, they will lift you high in their hands so that you will not strike your foot against a stone. You will tread on the lion and the snake. You will trample the great lion and serpent, because he loves me, he says the Lord. I will receive him and protect him for the Lord's name. He will call on me and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life, I will satisfy him and show him my salvation. Thank you for everything, Amma. I will miss you.
Thank you very much, Nathaniel. We now come to a penultimate tribute from Philip Akinseti, one of our stewarding team leaders who will be bringing a tribute this morning. Philip, thank you.
Served for a very long time in the stewarding team, for a very, very long time, and still as Christina. One thing that stood out for me, it was quite touching to see mother and daughter coming in our red scarf and the stewarding uniform on a Sunday, coming to serve the Lord, and to see Christina, as well, was very young, serving the Lord. This kind of thing provided inspiration for so many people, myself included, whereby I was able to introduce my own children to serve in the stewarding team, obviously on their own volition, but to introduce them, to encourage them to serve the Lord. And for me, that was something great to see. There was service year in, year out, for a very long time. She served diligently, and we thank God for her life. And I just pray for God, who knows all, who owns all, but who understands all. Because we don't usually understand things. I used to say that God knows best, but I stopped saying that after a while. I say only God knows, because that would suggest that I know anything. Only God understands why some things happen the way they do. Whilst we don't, we trust and have confidence in the Lord, who understands everything. May I so rest in my peace. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Philip. And our final tribute this morning comes from Christina, Amma's daughter.
Your tribute was one of the hardest things I've ever had to do. As I read this tribute, my heart is filled with immense sorrow. The fact that you are no longer with me hurts me more than anything else in this world. To explain how much you mean to me is an impossible task, but I'm willing to give it a try. Mummy, you were and still are my everything. My first love, twin sister, best friend, prayer partner, confidant, encourager, superwoman, motivation, disciplinarian, advocate, advisor, laughing buddy, fashion critique, and so much more. Mummy, you were the essence of love, a constant source of patience and understanding. Your gentle touch, reassuring smile, and endless devotion were a source of strength through the years. Ma, Your heart was like a rose, always open, always loving, and forever giving.
Mummy always gave without expecting anything in return. Mum gave regardless of you knowing her personally or not. Mum would call and pray for people, even though she was poorly herself. Everyone's burden was her burden. You could always count on Mum to be there for you through thick and thin. Ma, take pride in being a mother. She'd always say it was the best role that God gave her. Mum would beam with so much joy when called Akuya Mame. Mum vowed to take exceptionally good care of me, and she did just that. Ma, you single-handedly raised me into the woman that I am today. Without you, there would be no one. Your sacrifices, support, integrity, hard work, prayers, and motivation have gotten me to where I am today. Mum was determined to make something out of me. Therefore, she constantly pushed and encouraged me to be the best version of myself. Without my mother, I wouldn't have achieved all that I have achieved. My gratitude knows no bounds when it comes to Mummy. Mummy, thank you for not giving up on me. Even when times were tough and odds were against me, you still chose me. You always found a way to make things happen for us. You always fought so hard for me and showered me with prayers. How I wish you could be here to see me get married and have your grandbabies, as this was something your heart desired the most. Lord knows my mum would have made my wedding a joyous and jubilant ceremony. I promise to tell all my children about you. I promise to keep your memory alive. I'm so blessed to have you as my mother. It's an honor I don't take for granted. In my next life, I'm coming back to you, Mummy. You were the best mother a girl like me could ask for. I wouldn't want anyone else to be my mother. Mommy, I will forever miss you, especially the moments we'd laugh together, cry together, comfort each other, sing together, gist together, teaching each other, reassuring each other, giving each other side eyes, praying together, wearing matching clothes, our long car journeys where we would discuss everything and your warm kisses. I promise to keep your memory alive, and I pledge to make you proud. To the world's greatest mum, until we meet again, sleep well, my beloved.
Once in a while, an event happens that changes our lives forever. It leaves an indelible mark. Today is one such day, the passing of a loved one. Sometimes we know, sometimes we don't. But when it arrives, we know that those moments will never be the same again, and we cannot go back to relive moments or relive lives. We can only hold on to the memories,
the good times, the challenging times, that door has somehow closed. But yet today, we can find comfort. We can find hope that Jesus Christ is still Lord. He still rules. He still reigns. The Apostle Paul declared in 1 Thessalonians 4, verse 13, "Fellow believers, we do not want you to be ignorant about those who fall asleep, or to grieve like the rest of humanity who have no hope." And what Paul meant by falling asleep was death. We don't grieve without hope. We have hope in the next life that we will see our loved ones again. That is the heart of our walk and journey with Jesus. The time has come for departure. When we think about someone departing this earth, it's a painful process of saying goodbye, as has been so eloquently expressed today, and that process continues in the days and weeks that lie ahead. Amma was a woman of immense faith. We've heard that today. Her faith speaks of her relationship with God, speaks to acts of service, as we heard from Philip, for the Lord Jesus Christ. She kept the faith. Her death is not an admission of defeat, but a statement of victory. A victory that has been made possible by the death and the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ himself. Psalm 30, verses 4 and 5 declare, "Sing the praises of our Lord, you, his faithful people. Praise his holy name, for his anger lasts but a moment, but his favor lasts a lifetime. Weeping may endure for the night, but the joy comes in the morning." And so we can be comforted today, knowing that a saint is anyone who has faith in Jesus Christ, has gone home to be with the Lord. And I know that Amma would not want the focus to be on her today. She would want the focus to be on the Lord that she served so faithfully, that she consistently worshipped, she honored, she revered, she accepted in her own heart. A woman of great integrity, a woman of righteousness, a woman who knew no limits when it came to serving, a deeply devoted woman who was secure and steadfast in her unwavering love and adoration for Jesus Christ. As we've heard, she reached for, attained, and maintained the highest Christian standards of charity, integrity, righteousness, and honesty. Was she perfect? No, she was pretty close. That reality reflects our truth today. Nobody here is perfect, but we are all forgiven by the Lord Jesus Christ. And I'm encouraged and empowered by the final two verses from the book of Jude that declares, "To him who is able to keep you from stumbling and to present you perfect before his glorious presence without fault or blemish and with great joy, to the only God, our Savior, be glory, majesty, power, and authority through Jesus Christ our Lord before all ages, now and forevermore." So Amma's faith was a key factor in her life. It was always present. It bubbled up to the surface of every part of her walk. And it was visible to every person that interacted with her. It was a faith that grew deeper and stronger with every passing year. And we know that it was tried and tested in the final couple of years. And she was found faithful. Amen? She served the Lord out of a conviction, not convenience. And it was based out of a deep confidence and conviction in her heart about her purpose and her identity in Christ. Her labor of love and service in Kensington Temple is merely a snapshot of a heart filled with God's love, gratitude, and thanksgiving. She was rooted and established in her faith, and she was in it for the long haul, day by day, week by week, month by month, year by year. Like every true believer, her faith was tested and stretched, but it was never broken or diminished. Even in those moments, she remained anchored in Christ, because her favorite psalm declares, "Even though she walks through the valley of the shadow of death, she feared no evil."
She held tightly to God's promises, refused to let them go. We think of the words from the hymn, "Be still, my soul, the Lord is on your side. Bear patiently the cross of grief or pain, though thorny ways lead to a joyful end." Amma received her promotion to heaven on Saturday the 23rd of October, and I am certain that she heard the words from the Lord Jesus Christ, "Well done, good and faithful servant. Come, share in your master's happiness." When we think about verse 8 from Timothy's scriptures, from Paul's words to Timothy, "Now there is a store for me, the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award me on that day, not only me, but all those who have longed for his appearing." Her journey of faith, her story, is an encouragement and affirmation to us all to deepen our trust in God, to abide in his love, to memorize scripture, and to trust in his promises. It's an opportunity for us to reflect today on the goodness of God, on a life well lived, on a life poured out in dedication and service to the Lord, to others. Never put ourselves first, always put others first. And a life that reflects the goodness, the grace, and the glory of Jesus Christ. The blood of Jesus speaks a better word. Amen.
Amen.
Always and forever. And she's now in the arms of our loving Heavenly Father, enjoying a rich inheritance and a great reward, looking down at us even now, saying, "I've gone before you." She's enjoying her rest, her inheritance, from a life that has been poured out so diligently, so consistently, so faithfully for so long. Never sought the limelight, never sought approval or affirmation of man. She lived for the audience of one, the Lord Jesus Christ. And today we can all take in comfort, encouragement, but also a bit of blueprint on how to sit in prayer as we dedicate Amma to the Lord. We pray for Christina, the extended family, friends that are present here today. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the life of Amma Frimpomaa. We choose today to celebrate that life. Our hearts are filled with sorrow and sadness, questions with seemingly no answers. But you know best. You are Lord. Your ways are not our ways. Your ways are higher than our ways. Your thoughts are not our thoughts. Your thoughts are higher than our thoughts. And I pray that you, the God of all comfort, would stretch forth your righteous right hand to every person here under the sound of my voice to bring a measure of relief and comfort, peace and security, stability and a sense of solidarity for Amma's life. We've gathered today to celebrate that life, her promotion to heaven, that rich inheritance that she's undoubtedly enjoying even right now. And I pray that in the days and weeks that lie ahead, that you, the sovereign God, would continue to cover us, as the words read earlier from Psalm 91, but also the words in Psalm 5, verses 11 and 12, that surely you surround the righteous with a giant shield of love. How we need your love today, Lord Jesus. Wrap each of us in your arms. Bring comfort, bring strength, bring peace, and bring joy, because we know the weeping will last for the night, but the joy will come in the morning. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen and amen. Thank you for observing that. I want to bring, just before we have our final hymn this afternoon, just to give you some information about the burial. So you're welcome to put this into your telephone. The burial will be at 1 p.m., so more or less immediately following the service, at Alperton Cemetery. That is on Clifford Road in Wembley, and the postcode is HA01AF.
HA01AF. It's not in the order of service, so that's why I'm sharing it with us this afternoon, so that we can all be there promptly. Also, on the way out to your right-hand side, after you exit the main sanctuary, there is a book of condolence that Christina and the family would love and appreciate if everybody, or as many people as possible, could write a word of encouragement. Maybe there's a verse of scripture that's burning on your heart for the family at this sad time. You're welcome to complete that just outside, but I ask that we are efficient with that, as we need to be at the cemetery from people 1 o'clock, and just ask that we would honour that as much as possible. Family, I wonder if you could stand with me this afternoon as I invite Rosamund and Jordan back for our final closing hymn, Abide With Me. The words are on page 6. Thank you.
Darkness, deep and So we're going the way, yeah? Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I'm not afraid to die. Awesome.